folks, welcome. Excuse me. Hey, folks, welcome back to Natural Magic Building. And this, we're actually not going to be doing any building today. We're just going to be, actually, we are going to do some building, because, no, I'm not, because I did that already. Never mind. I was thinking I needed to put walls along this pier, but no, I don't. No, I don't. Okay, but we're just going to take a tour today of Beefnopolis and associated areas. Okay, little node. Okay, you can stay. You're a happy node. This was the first Archimedes ship we built. This was the test boat. The dinky dinghy. And then, of course, the Imperial Party Barge, which ended up having a lovely sunroof because I screwed up and put the canopy on wrong. Have the lighthouse over here. That I think I built at least part of this live on the Extra Life stream in 2014. And then I kind of realized that creative building was not going to keep me awake, so we switched to something else. So we got the wall here that goes all the way around. As we come into Pleb Village, we enter the Krusty Mug Inn. No, that's fine. Any parts laying around in here? Now there's a skull there. We'll go in through the back door. Where's the barkeep? Excuse me, barkeep. Where are you? Hello. I hear you, Marco. Oh, there he is. Oh, excuse me. He's making the beds. Okay. Running a tidy establishment here. I'm gonna grab me a little something here. Give me some juice. There we go. Give me that juice. Oh, I can't. I'm in creative. Okay. What about food? You got any food, bruh? You got any food laying around in here? Oh, anything in the fridge? Okay. Pardon me. We'll just put that away. Okay. And up here on the right, we have actually the first building I think I added to Pleb Village, not counting the wall. That being the stable. I think one of our horses is still here. Hey, buddy, how you doing? Oh, geez. Let me off. Sorry. Do I have any apples? I don't. All right. This was originally going to be the harbor, but other stuff happened, and as we come out of the harbor, I never did get around to fully kitting out the castle for Thaumcraft. Thaumcraft is one of those mods where I'll start to get into it, and I'll spend like a week running around with a thermometer scanning everything, and then I just kind of see something shiny and wander off. This is the witchery hut that I built because my witchery setup was starting to take over the apothecary's house. And at one point it kind of turned into a Batania setup when I didn't know what the hell I was doing with Batania. And that ended up getting folded into the agricultural magic lab in the castle. Anyway, back to... Oh! We must have had a meteor hit down here. Yep, sure enough. Okay. Anyway, back to our tour. This was where I originally stored all the creative crap. Oh, geez, I had another whole set of tools up here. I could have come back up after I dumped them all the last time. Forgot about that. This is one of the few functional things that we cheated in. Meteor shields. Because shortly before I started building anything here, well, the village was already here. But shortly before I started building, the entire subcontinent got pummeled with kitty comets. And it was terrible. I did add a hatch to the sewer. I did not do anything with the sewer. I meant to. And that never quite happened. But we'll do that in, we'll have a good sewer in Mod Sauce. I kitted some of these houses out with stuff. Not this one. Okay, that's still a vacant one. There's the old creepy ruins over here. Pumpkin patch. I think, yeah, here's one that I decorated up. Here we go. was that. And I think this one too. Yeah. Did I put any? No, I didn't put any goodies up here. Okay. Of course, the totally not the Assassin's Guild. I built this house. I actually built this house from scratch. And it became the Assassin's Guild because every time I came in here, there were two or three villagers standing around, and there would be a gravestone on the floor where they killed somebody, apparently. So that became the Assassin's Guild. That's a library that I redid. Kind of kept the vanilla village feel to it. That's the Undertaker. And the cemetery. This used to be Soul Sand. I needed to steal their Soul Sand. Let's see. We had a zombie problem here. Yeah. had some dead rising from the grave. It was terrible. Excuse me. There's the Tinker's Workshop. The Apothecary Hut, which I had used for my witchery. Sure enough, we got a man in the tub. This has been a running gag through the whole series. Every time I break this cauldron, somebody else would get in it. I'd come in here and there'd be two or three villagers in that cauldron. So, that just kind of became a running joke. We let it go. Because I couldn't keep them from doing it. They just get right back in. All right. Let's go back around here. And there was originally, I had something kind of sketched out here that ended up a wizard's tower that I ended up not building. Where's the market? This is the reputable butcher. This is the less than reputable butcher. And yeah. Oh, and the less than reputable butcher. I never replaced him. Oh dear. Okay. The witchery guy. The dino meat and artifacts guy. The music shop. Various forestry stuff, ironworks. And I redid the gate on the castle. I used the carpenter garage doors. We did this a couple of weeks ago. I didn't know these were a thing. That makes a much better castle gate. I wish they would all go together, though. First, we're not going to go in the castle just yet. We're going to go to the hovel, which is where I lived until the castle got into a complete enough state that I could safely live there. I guess I could fly. And I think, yep, there's an Elvis currently living there. Yeah, a hot mess of chests and junk everywhere. I took the bed out, right? This goes down to the mine. Excuse me, Elvis. Elvis somehow escaped the castle. Oh, okay, it's just... We just hadn't loaded. Okay. Now, bless these guys' hearts. They've been trying to figure out how this door works. They just gather around it, but they can't make it go. So this is the armory. And the upstairs smeltery got moved into here when I built this out. Why the villagers are congregating around that door and that particular door and no other, I don't know. This is where villagers get born. Like so. Here, let me just just hold still a second. There we go. And you just plant them right there. I'll just throw the extra one away. Oh, oh dear. There we go. And, oh, we're not getting an Elvis this time. We had a plague of Elvi in the castle. This is the movie theater. Now, one thing I had wanted to do was to change this texture every week and have it show a different movie. That is something I would like to do in Mod Sauce. So I'm going to build an actual movie theater. But we did this kind of the Alamo Draft House style with the food and adult beverages. In here we have the trophy room. Not a single one of these trophies is legit from this pack. I think, Did I find a dragon egg somewhere? Maybe. Maybe the heads are legit. The Erebus crap on the wall is legit. All the rest of it, I just kind of, you know, black marketed in. I have the billiards room. The man cave. I'm ridiculously proud of the stupid cue sticks. The table turned out okay. And it's... I think there actually is in DecoCraft a proper pool table, which will be nice. We'll talk about the fountain in a minute. All right, this is a room that I actually didn't build out on camera. This is the tea house, the tea room. I know all pastel and finger sandwiches and little bites and things. The library with bookshelves, both decorative and functional. Let me get a sip here. There we go. The fitness center. How do you do a treadmill without the Mind Factory Reloaded conveyor belts? Well, very carefully, that's how. And a little pull-up bar. Hup, hup. I should have put some slime blocks in. Oh, I can take that down. That was a note sign there. Towels, got a bench there. The Agricultural Magic Center, which is the Botania and Magical Crops stuff. And let's see, no, my skellies and my creepers are still growing. I think I do have a whole mess of meat. Let's see, is it? There we go. We'll put that on the ship. Then we'll put that in the crate. This was the fossils and archaeology room. I didn't really get that much into fossils. I kind of did, but not really, you know. Ah, relic scrap, hey. Is that the right thing to make this go? No, you have to restore it. Poop. Let's see. Where's the... There it is. Here, give me this. Give me this. Give me this. All right, fix that. I think I might sneeze. there we go. Excuse me. Okay, that's what I need. A stone tablet. No, 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 not you. No, maybe not. Okay. So what? Oh, that's how you do it. Okay. All right. Well, never mind. Let's just put those somewhere. Oh, geez. The Erebus room I kind of went overboard on and had way too much fun with. Let's just put them in here. Let's just put this in here. There we go. Had way too much fun with the Erebus room. Because the portal has this beacon thing going on. So I thought, you know, it'd be kind of cool to make it look like the Erebus is leaking into the overworld. So I brought a bunch of... some of the stuff is legit, some of it is not. And this, of course, is the first fully decorated room in the castle. This is the Red Room. The Twin Peaks homage. Complete with Garmin Bogia. Yeah. All right, while we're over here, let's talk about the courtyard. This is where the castle actually started to be built. It was around this fountain right here. And this fountain was the original entrance to the mine level. Because if you look down here, it's a water ladder. I had actually done this way back in the day, before I ever even started doing Let's Plays. I did this in a mansion I built in the Minecraft mod pack way back in the day. Then I did another one that was hidden in a well in my front yard. Oh my god. And this is why we built the other mine entrance, because this is a pain in the butt. Speaking of which, well, no, let's not. Let's not. Nether portal's down here. We'll just fly back up. That'll be faster. Yeah. There we go. Now, the fountain itself has a feature, has some statues around it. these are the heavy hitters. These are the big donors to Extra Life. And except for a bloke here, in his case, he actually donated games for me to give away during the stream. So, which brings me to something. If you would like to see your statue in the Mod Sauce or have a street named after you, all you have to do is donate to Extra Life. I'm going to get set up again. I'll put a link up on all the places I put links once that's done. So you can throw money at Texas Children's Hospital. Here we have the constabulary, the constable's office, complete with very important detectoring supplies, which leads down into the dungeon. I think Edward's still in here, too. Edward the Bat? Yep, there he is. Yep, there's Edward. You know what you did? I don't have to tell you. I think I accidentally hit him in the head while I was decorating here. I had these cells dark on purpose so that things might occasionally spawn in them. I don't think I ever caught anything spawning in them. And of course, now that we're on perma peaceful, that's not going to happen. All right, up we go. All right, close that. All right, keep up the good work, officer. Armory we've seen, and everybody's still around the door. Where's the new guy? Where's the new guy? The new guy? New guy. Hello, new guy. Did he go to the armory with the rest of them? He did. He joined the rest of the villagers in the armory. Okay, that's a forestry guy. That's a bee guy. And some of the comet kitties that I tamed. Well, that one is a child of comet kitties. Where's the actual comet kitty? There's one down here, and then there's one upstairs. Right, there he is. Okay. I got something in my eye here. All right. Yep, I don't need to fly. I'll sprint, though. We have down here the Dirt Army Barracks. Blocklings are a thing in this pack. So I recruited a whole bunch of blocklings to be the Dirt Army. Private Humus, Captain Fair, yeah. They sleep in compost bins. They have their training dummies. There is actually... there's a training dummy buried down here somewhere. Yeah, there it is. Because I couldn't make it go away. It wouldn't go away. I couldn't break it. I mean, if you... You can't make it go away. I'm in creative. I'm punching it. It won't go away. I tried hitting it with weapons. I tried all manner of things. No, they just stone cold will not go away. Here's the kitchen. And you know, little music, little burn stand there. Why did I make these? Oh yeah, that's right. I made those to christen the party barge with. Various cookware. Ah yeah, the machines that I don't really need. Because that was apparently not implemented yet. Pizza oven. That was the Benny's, whoa, distilling stuff. The pantry in here. And of course this leads to, excuse me, the dining hall. A couple more statues, Jugsy and Optimus here. Come on, nope. That cake's been sitting there since I made it for the quest book. It's kind of stale. So let's just leave it there. It's kind of nasty. All right. Up here on the second floor, we'll go outside. We had some of our gardens on the roof, and I'll fly around. We had a little thing here. Mistletoe, yeah. And we'll just go back on around to the ballrooms. This was the disco ballroom. And that's why I'm still growing skeleton and creeper seeds down there, is to make records. To turn the... Yeah, to put in the disco ballroom. This is the traditional formal ballroom here. And then up the staircase in the middle. First, we'll go to, let's do them in order that I did them. Have the red room, the guest room. This is before I discovered the paint can. The writer's room. Now, the paint mixer is probably one of the most wonderful things. The yellow bedroom. The green room. Oh, hey, buddy. How you doing? Oh, no, no thank you. Okay, just make yourself at home. I'll close the door. I had expected the villagers to be a little bit more gung-ho about playing with these doors, but they really weren't. Let's do them in order, I said. So the blue room actually turned out to be more of a cyan and tan room. Is that... yeah. This is the fossils and Erebus stuff here. The purple room turned out to be an ender bedroom. And I discovered too late the Ganny's item displays. Which I should have known they were in here, because I've played with Ganny's before. The pink bedroom. This was originally going to be the carpenter garage doors, but I decided the paper walls looked better. And finally, the blue and black room. The little Andy Warhol thing on the wall here. Okay, and finally, we have here the throne room. And a couple other important people. Important donors, very important Knights of Beefnopolis. Go to the secret door here. This is my private chamber. I'm gonna look at the quest book. As the quest book at one point just went completely pear-shaped. Yeah, zero completed quests. I had been working on them. I'd been working on the quests, and then all of a sudden it just forgot. It just forgot that I had done all the quests. I can watch TV from the bed. There we go. My bathroom, I got my bathrobe, I got my slippers. I got my sink, I got... No, I thought I had some medicine in there. Have reading material and other paper. I have a hot tub, lava heated, boy. There we go. Little steam shower there. I meant to put in like a pool table or some exercise equipment over here. That just never really happened because I put those in other rooms in the castle. This is probably the thing that I'm most proud of in this room right here. This is my big screen TV playing heavy metal videos. Of course, with the remote sitting there. And my interwebbing chair. My private bar. With a beer in the cookie jar. Let's see. Got lots of fish. Lots of other stuff. Go down one more to the vault. I made all these chests. I put all these chests in, and I used like one full wall of them. Plus, you know, maybe one column. But I put the paint mixer down here. Put a bunch of junk down here. Put the ender seeds down here. And this goes all the way down. This is the second smeltery. What did I was looking for copper or something down here, wasn't I? And of course, this goes all the way down back to the mine level. There we go. And to conclude our tour, we're gonna do a little fly around and look at the wall, and then I'll take you back to spawn. And from there, we're going to go on to our next great adventure. There we go. There we go. Here's the wall. I did not quite finish decorating the towers. Oh well. That's what happens when you get cheap labor, you know. And fly over of Pleb Village. Go back to spawn. Back to where we began. Well, we sure did get lit up by a lot of meteors. Huge meteors became crashed into us repeatedly. I think I'm heading back to spawn. I'm not sure. I don't think I've ever flown all the way back to spawn. Let me check the map. Let me make sure that's where I'm going. Yeah, that's where I'm going. Okay. Witch house. I never... Huh. More meteors. Spawn is where we had our first silverfish apocalypse. That was awful. Had a couple of silverfish apocalypses. And they were still awful. Ah, yeah. Oh, God. Look at this cobble generator. Isn't this horrible? I think I found a paintbrush in a chest or something and used it to paint this so I'd know to not break it. Fruit trees, cows running around wild, little garden. Yeah. This was actually here. This was a ruin that I kind of built back up, just so I could have some shelter while I scouted out a good spot. Moo! Yes, that's right. Is the bed still there? The bed is still there. Nope. Okay. And I've still got some veggies and junk here. Wow. Oh, wow. I've got some stuff in the crate. How about that? Oven set in the wall. Bunch of junk over here. Copper and stuff. Okay. All right. Well, we'll just stand out here. So. Oops. What am I doing? There we go. Thank you, space! Boy. Well, folks, thank you for joining me for this year-plus long project of building Beefnopolis out. We'll be back next week with Hermitcraft Mod Sauce 2 Creative. So I will see you then. Take care, folks. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.